Let me tell you a story, a kōrero of a carved meeting house that once travelled far, far from home and has returned. Finally, after being away for more than 100 years, the carvings, our ancestors, our tipuna, are with us again. To understand the journey of this meeting house and how it came to travel so far from the shores of Whakatāne, we need to go back in time. Back to the 1870s. To a time when the people of Ngāti Awa are struggling to hold on to land, to life, and to hope. They are reeling from land confiscations by the Crown and epidemics of introduced illnesses such as typhoid, whooping cough, and measles have taken the lives of many Ngāti Awa, especially the children. The area is under military surveillance, and 33 of the iwi's men have been imprisoned in Auckland. In these turbulent times, an idea is born to build a carved meeting house to celebrate the ancestors of Ngāti Awa and to unite all the tribes of Mātaatua, the great waka that landed at Whakatāne more than 700 years ago. It is time for a show of strength. Kia kaha, kia kaha. And so, with Wepiha Apanui as the master carver and architect, a beautiful wharenui is built. White pine is used for the spine, and tōtara dug from the Whakatāne riverbed is carved into the main figures. Among these are two sets of twins, Tarakiuta and Tarakitai, and the warriors Wahahamama and Tai Timuroa, who stand on each side of the amo. Mātaatua is magnificent. Even today's standards, it is huge, 24 metres long, 12 metres wide, and nearly 7 metres high. After 3 years of building and carving, the wharenui is officially opened in March 1875. The celebrations continue for 3 days, and Native Affairs Minister Donald McLean attends as a special guest. Mātaatua is to be a house for the Queen of England. This dedication means that if she comes to Aotearoa, she has a home at Whakatāne. The New Zealand government sees other meanings in this generous tribute to a people whose main desire is to have their imprisoned men released. So, when a carved meeting house is needed for the British Empire exhibition in Sydney, the wharenui fit for a queen is the perfect choice. Against the wishes of Ngāti Awa's vocal kuia, Mātaatua is disassembled, labelled and packed into a steamship called the Staffa, a boat small enough to fit inside the meeting house itself. In 1879, the boat leaves Whakatāne with its precious cargo. And so begins the wanderings of New Zealand's most travelled meeting house. The Ngāti Awa elders have asked that one of their people travel with Mātaatua to help assemble the building, but the offer is turned down. This is to be a grave error of judgment, one that leads to the house being permanently damaged. Once in Sydney, the wharenui is erected, but its walls are turned inside out. Instead of the carvings and tukutuku panels being protected by the body of the house, they are put on the exterior in full view of the visitors. There is no pōhiri, no thought to Māori protocol. The house is simply put up wrongly, placing the intricate woven panels and ancestral carvings of Ngāti Awa at the mercy of a Sydney summer. In April 1880, after 7 months of being on show, the wharenui is packed up and taken to the Melbourne International Exhibition. This runs from October 1880 to April 1881. There are no photos of Mātaatua at this event, and so it's not known if the house is subjected to the same inside-out treatment as in Sydney. At the end of the Melbourne show, Mātaatua is again packed up and taken away, all the way to London. Here, the meeting house is erected in the grounds of the South Kensington Museum. Photos of the carved house show, this time, it's put up correctly. How long Mātaatua stays here is not known, but records reveal the house is still there in 1883. But not for long, it seems. The meeting house is dismantled and stored in the cellar of the Victoria and Albert Museum for more than 40 years. Mātaatua comes to light again in 1924 when it is erected for the British Empire exhibition at Wembley. And finally, the Wharenui fit for a queen becomes just that. During the exhibition, Queen Mary and King George visit the carved meeting house and are photographed on the front veranda. Another visitor is Māori guide Maggie Papakura, who is married to an English gentleman. She cries over the house, feeling its sorrow for standing there alone, like her in a country far from home. However, Mātaatua is soon to head back to Aotearoa, but not to its home in Whakatāne, not yet. The New Zealand government negotiates the return of the meeting house, which is shipped to Dunedin for the South Seas exhibition in 1925. Once again, Mātaatua becomes a showpiece, and then behind the scenes, deals are struck and the house becomes a permanent exhibit at the Otago Museum. By this time, Mātaatua is battered in need of repair. Long ocean voyages, overland horse and dray journeys, and being repeatedly put up and pulled down have taken their toll. The Otago Museum repairs the carved house, but in trying to fit the tall house into the museum, the carvings of Ngāti Awa's ancestors are shortened. They are simply lopped off at the bottom. This squat version of the majestic Mātaatua sits in the Otago Museum for another 71 years, despite ongoing requests by Ngāti Awa for its return. Finally, in 1996, after years of negotiations, a Waitangi Tribunal Special Deed of Settlement sees the release of the Great Carved Meeting House. After 117 years, the carvings, our ancestors, our tipuna, are able to come home. Mātaatua's long journey is almost over. A dozen years have passed, with them the healing of wounds and the rejuvenation of our damaged wharenui. Fresh carvings have been hewn under the guidance of Ngāti Awa Master Carver, Te Hau o Te Rangi Tutua, who has now passed on. Mātaatua has been given new life by its people. Now it's time for the wandering carved meeting house to rise up again in the heart of Whakatāne, its tūranga waiwai, and the place where it all began.